Blah, or whatever.
Hey Dino fans, D-Rex here. Today we're going to take a look at the Jurassic World Battle Damage Matchbox, as well as the Jurassic World Kawasaki Brute Force 750, which is in the scene with the raptor chase in the original Jurassic World. If we take a look at the individual packages, we can see that each one has an illustration of the vehicle in the package. They also have the Jurassic World logo, and the Battle Damage ones have the Battle Damage logo. All the Matchbox are for ages 3+, and on the back of the package, we also see the Jurassic World logo, and it's gray, but it's the same background as the blue background with the collection picture. And we have, of course, all of the various warnings and copyright information on the back. The assortment number for regular vehicles is FMW90. The Brute Force is FMX13. The Battle Damage assortment is FVR56. And the Gyrosphere is FVR57. The Textron Tiger is FVR61. This one they're calling the Armored Action Truck this time. It is FVR58. The Submarine is FVR59. And the Mercedes-Benz G-Class is FVR60. The assortment for the 5-pack is FVR67, and the product number is V as in Victor, R68. It should be noted that, unlike other sets, the individual battle damage vehicles are exactly the same as the 5 vehicles in the 5-pack. You'll notice here on the 5-pack, we have the Jurassic logo front and center, and the upper right-hand corner has the battle damage logo. This one they're calling the Island Transport Team. And the back of the package this time shows the Matchbox haulers from Wave 1, as well as the Jurassic World logo and all of the warnings and information about copyright. Before we open the Battle Damage pack, let's take a look at the Kawasaki Brute Force 750. The Kawasaki Brute Force 750 looks pretty much like it does in the movie. It's even the dark green color that we see Barry riding during the raptor chase scene. Has the headlights on the front, and also a Jurassic logo above the Kawasaki name. You can see here they've even sculpted side details. You can see the inner workings of the ATV. You see it does say on the bottom, 2018 Mattel. Top view. And this is of course not in scale with the other vehicles, but that's kind of nice in this instance because it is more in scale with the mini action dino velociraptors that we have. There also is a version of Owen's motorcycle available. I have not found it yet. If I do, I will update you in a future video. Let's open the Battle Damage 5-pack and take a closer look at the battle damage on each of the vehicles. I won't be going into detail about the sculpts because we've already looked at that very closely in our review of the original vehicles, and these are exactly the same vehicles with the exception of painted on dino damage. Now some of them already had scratches in the mold, but on this set they have actually painted them so that the scratches look fresh and there's dirt on the different vehicles. The battle damage is much more visible on the battle damage matchbox. Here's our first example. We have the Mercedes, and you can see here that all of the scratch marks have been painted black, and there is mud and dirt painted all over the side of the vehicle. There's no dino damage on the top, but there is considerable damage on the other side. And we have our armored truck. Same thing. We can see that it's been driven through the mud quite a bit, and that the scratches are painted black, so they are much more visible. Here's a look at the passenger side. Now this one actually does have some damage sculpted on the top, but for some reason they've chosen not to paint those scratches. Probably just something they missed. I'm not sure why they didn't paint that, but it doesn't really take away from the overall look, because you're not looking, there's also some here on the hood. You're not really looking at the top of the vehicle much when you display it. You're probably going to be looking at it from the side. Here we have the white Textron Tiger. And you can see that it also has mud and scratches. None on the top. Here's the other side. We have the front of the vehicle and the back of the vehicle also clean. Again, you're probably going to display this from the side. If we take a look at the gyrosphere, the thing I noticed about it right away is that there's dirt on both sides. You can see there's the back. And there's the, what would be the front, I guess. So you could display this with either side. You could display it not broken or broken. Or you could turn it around so that the unbroken, unmuddy side is showing. But they've also added the white star pattern here. This is to indicate broken glass. Or in this case, it would be the broken acrylic dome. Nothing too complex, but it does make a difference in the way the vehicle looks. And I figured the submarine would be a great example to show you that they are in fact the same vehicle. You can see here, same sculpt, same paint. I originally wasn't sure because I didn't really remember the yellow here on the bottom on the front on all the little tanks and lights, but it's there. You can see same sculpt, same color, same everything, with the exception of the again, the kind of spiderweb or star pattern broken glass on the front. There you have it, Dino fans. That's pretty much it for the battle damage Matchbox cars and the Kawasaki Brute Force. The battle damage is supposed to be exclusive to Walmart. I'm sure that other places will start to carry it eventually, and you'll also want to be wary because scalpers will probably pick these up and try to sell them at a much higher price than they should be. But you really shouldn't spend more than about $5 for the whole set. And while we're at it, I just reached over real quick and grabbed the metallic Mini Action Dino Blue. And I just wanted to show you again, the Kawasaki is in scale with the Mini Action Dino Raptors. For the most part, I think it looks pretty good together. I suppose now is as good a time as any for some real talk. I don't know how many of you are on Twitter. There's currently a campaign on Twitter under the hashtag SaveTheSpino because the rumor is that Target is not going to restock it and they may not stock the rest of the Mattel line, which I think is absolutely crazy. It's utterly bonkers to me. Why would they do that? Why would they not want our money? I mean, everybody I know wants a Spino. And there's no reason why we should have to pay $60+ to import it from our friends in the UK and other countries because we're supposed to have it here in the United States. So if you're on Twitter and you would like to see the rest of the line in your Target store, especially the Spino, the Legacy Ian Malcolm, the future of the line, you should contact Target Corporate and let them know. Tweet them, tweet at Target or at Ask Target. I've posted the information on my Facebook page, Dibosaurus Rex. You can also probably find it on my Twitter if it's not buried under political nonsense. I'm really having a difficult time getting Mattel or Target or Walmart to respond to me these days. I know that the Christmas season is coming. Everyone's going to go shopping on Black Friday. People are going to be buying things, and one of the things that people would like to buy is this amazing line of toys that Mattel has created. I mean, here on my desk you can see this is what I could grab within arm's reach. My entire office is full of this stuff, and I want more of it. I don't want less, I want more. Target, yo, take my money. I want to buy the things. It doesn't make any sense to me, so I'm going to continue trying to get them to respond to me, and hopefully they will stock the Spino and Ian and the rest of the line. We're supposed to get a Legacy Dilophosaurus and a Legacy Gallimimus. They're still listed on the Target website as out of stock, but anytime anybody in the United States has tried to ask them, they just say, well, we don't know when we're going to get it. It's a little aggravating to me, and probably to you too. So, anyway, just make sure that they know that you're looking for the toys in your area. Contact corporate. Don't bother with the store, because the stores can't really do anything about it. I mean, the store managers have a regional manager who has... It's a whole thing. Just contact corporate. Again, at Target or at Ask Target on Twitter. One final note about contacting Mattel and Target. Please be kind. They are just doing their jobs. And while we're frustrated and we really would like to see the items on the shelves and in stock online, it's best to approach the situation like they're already trying, and they want to make you happy as their customer. So just keep that in mind. I don't really know what's going on, so there's not really any reason to treat them poorly or to be angry at any one individual that you speak to. Something my grandmother always said is that you catch more flies with honey. So, you know, just keep that in mind. Try to be nice, but do keep asking them. Don't give up. And hopefully we'll see the Spino soon. Again, that's the Twitter hashtag, SaveTheSpino. As for the toys that are already out, you should be seeing Zia and the Mercenary, the Ankylosaur, the Pteranodon. I've seen probably every store has a half a dozen Stegosaurs. Like, Walmart has an entire end cap of the original Indoraptor figures. I've seen Wave 1 and 2 in stock everywhere. I've seen Red Raptors and Red Hararosaurs. And I gotta be honest, most of the things that I've wanted to buy from Target, I found them at Walmart first. So, I mean, I feel bad for Target almost, because by the time they get it in stock, we've already found it mostly at Walmart. I don't know what the deal is. I don't know why it is that way. That may be something Mattel and Walmart can work on together, but hopefully that, at least that part of it doesn't change. Hopefully Walmart will continue to have items in stock. As of the other day, they still had the Baryonyx Lava playset in stock. They are supposed to have the very limited release of the Battle Damage Lockwood stuff. There's supposed to be a Battle Damage Gallimimus. The other thing I've seen is the Pteranodon Fossil Strikers, and I bought this online from Target, but just today I went to another one of my local Targets, and they had it in stock. So that's something you can be looking out for. If you're still looking for Wheatley, go to Target. Almost every Target I've been to has one. They also have Lockwood Battle Owen. I know it's frustrating, and I know it's difficult to wait, but the one thing I urge you not to do is to buy from scalpers, because scalpers are buying up stock and marking it way up to ridiculous prices, and they want to charge you ridiculous shipping. Don't buy from scalpers. It's not something we want to encourage. I don't want the scalpers to profit from frustrated little kids that are trying to put stuff on their birthday list and their Christmas list. I don't want them to profit from frustrated parents who can't find a thing that their kid just gotta have. In general, I don't like them at all. And I don't want to support their habit. So if you don't buy from scalpers, there'll be no market and they'll stop doing it. They'll move on to some other toy line and they'll leave us alone, hopefully. The other thing I've seen a lot in stock is the Colossal Rexes. Walmart has the Battle Damage one and Target has the regular one. They're everywhere. You don't have to worry about it at all. Just go pick one up if you want it. Something else I wanted you to know is that I am once again working on my life-size, real, for-me-to-drive Jurassic Park Jeep. It's getting its fender repaired this weekend, and hopefully I will put the fender flares on this week and get the red stripes on soon thereafter. And then it'll be a race to finish assembling everything. And I hope to have it at a car show at the end of the month. I will keep you updated. Everybody keep your fingers crossed that there are no more hiccups in the schedule. And we will see what we can do to get the Jeep on the road. If you are interested in building a Jurassic Park Jeep, or a Jurassic Ford Explorer, or some other movie vehicle or tribute vehicle, consider contacting the Jurassic Park Motor Pool. It's really just a great group of guys to talk to while you're building your Jeep or Explorer. If you happen to see one of us on the road, don't be shy. Honk, wave, take pictures, say hi. Everybody's really nice that I've met so far, and we absolutely love it when people love our vehicles. I feel like this is kind of a long video, but I felt the need to address certain issues, and hopefully you feel the same about some of these things. And in the meantime, don't forget to like and share this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon to be notified when I upload a new video. I'll be doing my best to keep my schedule. If for some reason a video is late or doesn't show up on time, again, assume that I am working on my Jeep, because that is obviously going to take priority for the month of October. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. If you want to keep in touch on social media, the best way is to find the Facebook page. It's Debosaurus Rex. Or the Jeep page, which is JP11 Movie Car Replica. That's all for now, Dino fans. Until next time, happy hunting.